Well, it's not broken. I wouldn't say it's broken, but I would say it is overtuned. So they should tune it down. But I mean, like, if you tune down the damage, people are mad. Luckily, they didn't. The damage is actually stronger. Like, with this build, the damage is actually slightly stronger in the PTR. Now, we're not talking about firepower yet. We'll talk about the firepower for now. But I mean, like, the barrage is actually stronger. A little bit, right there. But the damage distribution is different now. It's more weighted on the wheelchair. Which is supposed to be because you're playing wheelchair, not firepower, right? So there is that as well. So I tested it already, 5x3 and 2 basically. So that's like the max setting in Korea. Level 2 all out attack, because you can use all out attack now, right? In the wheelchair basically. So yeah, and also at the same time, it makes this build much cheaper as well. Since like the damage is now weighted, every time will be people happy and others sad. Well, that's basically what balance change is, right? You know, the people, the class that are OP gets tuned down. The class that are like weaker gets like gets buffed basically. That's normal. But obviously people are not happy because they want their class to be the strongest, and then they want like the other classes to be shit. So yeah, this dude is so despair. I haven't read it fully. But let's go, man. Let's go. Anyways, let's go. It is ding dong react time. This is second PTR, right? So this is Surge 2.0. Back in the day, in the first PTR, the Surge player were the one that was complaining, you know, we need to be refunded with peons or something like that. Now it's mandatory Surge 3. I have to make all the engraving again. So yeah, that kind of things right there. So it's gonna be interesting right here. When I need unloading my lorry. But yeah, let's go. Still waiting on the refund. Here we go. So this guy, Jaden Shuffle here, is an artillery's main. So yeah, let's see. Let's read up on this right here. Since yesterday, having my first real Lost Ark depression. Yeah, when log on my RT and watch my setup, which has cost me everything, can't help but feel a deep sadness. When I think how I could improve my character even more, max tripod, honing, trying to finalize the 5x3, I'm just like, eh, after all, what for? Am I going to become another Shadow Hunter copy pasta? You're implying you weren't? 4 skills to use with big cooldown while being rooted, losing the 20% damage reduction. You actually don't lose it, by the way. It just goes down to like 10%, because 20% is obviously kinda busted, you know. And back to normal form with low damage skill. Not sure we can even call it copy pasta at this point. Artillery is a unique class, and that's why it's fun to play. I don't understand why they want to apply the same pattern other classes have. You're literally the same class as the other transform though. Like, you're making it like it's totally different, like it's a unique one. No, you're just transformed. The difference is you can't move, and you have like 4 skills instead of 6. That's basically what it is. And if you're thinking that's the unique part, then you still have the same thing. You still can't move. You still only have 4 skill anyway. I'm unique. Not all of them, Akashi, man. I have 25. So yeah, anyways, yeah, I will enjoy every minute of the few time left with wheelchair RT, but I can't project myself in the future as it is. Class balance is a thing, completely changing a class design is another. The class design is the same! Dude, I played it already in PTR, like yesterday I did like so testing for so long. I don't know, am I overreacting? For sure, 100%. Too pessimistic? I don't know, I mean like pessimistic about what? About like its damage or about its class design? Because yes, you are if that were the case. I don't know. Please, KR artilleries, make some noise. They did make some noise. But you know what the noise are though? It's not that the class playstyle is changed. Because the playstyle didn't change. It's just because they have to like basically change like their double class engraving, because they have been abusing double class engraving forever. You know? Doomers, I don't know, I mean like literally nothing changed about like the artilleries aside from like some of its like gameplay and like the damage distribution right here. But you play wheelchair to play wheelchair, right? Or are you playing wheelchair to play 30% firepower with 70% wheelchair? Which one are you playing, right? What's the problem? I'm not sure, but this is how it is. We're reading on this. I did some testing already on artilleries, so I know exactly what the numbers already. And we'll get through the numbers later. Yeah, and speaking of which, this is still PTR by the way, things can still change, it's still PTR. So yeah, it's not like real server yet, not even live server. Once it's live server, then maybe like it will be more concrete. But right now, we don't even have like any exact info. But then I think there is a reply, right? There is a reply. I feel bad for Shadow Hunters now, why? if you're gonna quit a class because of balance patch, you were never main, just an abuser. I mean, here's the thing, right, you know? Whenever, like, If you're gonna quit because a balance patch nerfs your class, even though it's obviously overtuned, right? Then just pick a bad class, so you'll not never reroll. But obviously that's not the case, because like what they like is abusing, like, you know, something that is like really strong, right? That's what they want. And then obviously if it's overtuned, then they get tuned down. Like the Surge Blade. Surge Blade last PTR got tuned down. Everyone was matched and molding right now. Look at the numbers right now. Surge Blade is still like higher high. It's still stronger. What happened to those people that say Surge is dead right here? I didn't read that, but I mean like I heard some people say that right there. Wonder who said that. I don't know. I mean like I just went on PTR. I went and tested the number, and then it's there on the live server. Went and tested as well. Got the number. Done. Problem solved. I don't know. That's the difference right there. I don't know. Well, let's move on right here. There is a reply right here. Probably gonna get downvoted, but whatever. To all wheelchair artillerists crying on every single thread about the rework, you should have seen it coming. You kinda have should have seen it coming. You know, technically, like, double class engraving have always been, like, a shit one, you know. And summoner, fortunately, usually the double class engraving one are just mainly summoner. There are some other class, of course, but I mean, like, generally, it's just summoner. But they, but we know for a fact they're going away from it. So yeah, so I mean like you should expect it to be there. So yeah, is the one I posted, is this yours or what? I don't know. It's not fair that your items are basically worthless now, I get it, but again, you should have seen it coming. This build was too overtuned and you were abusing it like there was tomorrow. Not exactly wrong, but I mean like it's right there, you know. Yeah, basically had everything. It was like playing Shadow Hunter with both engravings synergizing with each other, so you have huge damage and nice combos in human form, turn into demon and have even more damage. Who wouldn't want this? That's how wheelchair artillerist works right now. I mean like kinda, I guess. In a way kinda. They kinda like that. So yeah. But he's way more tanky than Shadow Hunter as well, and his range. It's just more fair that you focus on one playstyle, and you can literally have everything and call it a day. I mean, like, people are gonna say that, like, you know, oh, but you can't move. Here is the thing about you can't move, right? Yes, you can't move. But you're way tankier with, like, way higher, like, health and armor coefficient, and you have firepower, reducing your damage by 20%, and then you have access to two shields that you can stack outside and inside of transform, outside and inside of, like, barrage mode, basically. So even if you can't move, you can just tank everything anyway. I mean, yeah, sure, if you're playing Brailheart, maybe you can argue this. But you're not Brailheart. You're on Valtan and Vikas. Not like you have to move anyway, exactly, yeah. Yeah, Crit Swift got some nice buff. Actually, that buff is too is a bit big, but we'll talk about it later right there. Yeah, while a dedicated wheelchair doesn't seem weak on paper as well. It's actually slightly stronger. In case people were wondering, the wheelchair in the PTR is slightly stronger actually. So yeah, class itself won't be bad after the changes, it just won't have everything at once anymore. Yeah, well, that's basically how it is there. Bosa, thank you for following, welcome dude. Welcome, 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 welcome. Meanwhile, I get pushed while casting Doomsday. Rip right there, yeah. Surface OP at the moment and the nerf 2%, last specialist OP nerf 50%. It wasn't 50% by the way, Kappa. It wasn't 50%. It was like around like, what, 10%? 10-12% or something, but it was like overtuned in a way. I mean, like, you saw how it is, right? So yeah, it's a different thing over there. Surge nerf was like 7% because like not all of your damage comes from the surge itself. The rest didn't actually get nerfed, right? So it's actually like less in terms of like numbers. But yeah, that's basically how it's here. Is there TLDR to RT changes? You should just read the patch notes, to be honest. Exclamation PTR, Ikigami. Yeah, I don't know. This is the one right here. We'll go through like everything, and I'll do like the numbers and everything later. So yeah, but this is like the other one right here. This is the last post right here about like the artillery smarting right here. So yeah, okay. Does Asi know he didn't play PTR? I did. Well, I mean like he knows like how the thing. He knows the PTR probably from like the patch note, but he probably didn't do any testing, so he doesn't know. So if you think that like, you know, wheelchair is dead or something like that, or like essentially deleted right here, essentially deleted, then like, I don't know where you get your info. So yeah, PTR is not even finalized yet. It's not even in live server. Once it's in live server, then cheer. So yeah. I saw Artie like a gunlancer with range skill that couldn't move with twice the damage of any class. You're basically blue gunlancer but ranges with like higher damage basically. In a way kinda. At least in your content right now. So yeah, there are some content in the Korea, like let's say Brailleheart, where like if you can't move then like it's pretty hard. But I mean like, you know, that's how it is. So yeah, but I mean like in NAU content right now, everything you can just tank it, dude. So yeah. Heard that engraving price barely move in KR after PTR when NAU price skyrocket? Yeah, because NAU right there. In KR, it barely moved, no. It barely moved. The only thing that moved pretty big was Summoner. That was it right there. And it's not like move pretty big. It goes from like 900 to 1800. That's it, basically. Because like now, like you see that like they want, they kind of want class level 3 on like one of its class engraving. So, yeah. But yeah, anyways, yeah. Okay, let's move on for this one right here. This is the last one right here. Yeah, it is unacceptable. Your main character can be essentially deleted anytime they are in the mood for a balance patch. So this is the kind of person that doesn't even do the number, doesn't even know the number, and they just say that it's essentially deleted. So yeah. Just got a massive revamp on the current PTR. It drastically changed the two class engraving, skills, tripods, combat stats. Actually, they're generally similar in a way on all of this right here. The only difference is the class engraving now, because they don't synergize together anymore. So yeah, with it, players have to invest thousands of gold to repurchase all their accessories, ability stone, legendary book setup, skill tripod, new gems. Some things they have to right now can still be used, but good majority things need to be redone from the ground up. And again, it's because you were abusing something that was like obviously overtuned, right? Obviously overtuned, and then you gear up for the overtuned deck, and then like when it's like tuned down, that's what happens basically. So yeah, I mean, hey man. If you want the damage to be nerfed so that like, you know, it's not overtuned, probably it's fine, but double class engraving sucks. It just sucks, man. It's just so expensive to make double class engraving. But I mean like, if people want that, then sure. So yeah, these people must have never played any other MMO if they are like surprised Pikachu when a character they play gets changed. Well, I mean, it wasn't me right there. Welcome to MMO, if you want nothing to change, play a single player game. Well, here is the thing, right, you know? Like, I've done the number of this, but we'll go through this first one. So yeah, all the while facing insane price gouging because the demand suddenly skyrockets and everything relative will go up 2 and 10 times in price. That's you. That's NAU. That's an NAU problem. That was not Korean problem. Like, we don't even like have like this kind of like price spike. That's just you guys. You guys made it for yourself. Needless to say, to the average player, this essentially means your character is deleted. Not really. It is most egregiously felt on your main character because the higher you dig into progression system, the cost gets exponentially higher. I mean, like, you have to change the engraving, but it's not like the engraving that you had is useless now. It's still there. So yeah, the art change is a good change. I think it's a good change because it separates the two, so it's no longer double class. Yeah, of course you can reply in the comments with stuff like, well, sucks for artillerists, I guess, but the reality is, you know, whenever this happens to you, you are most likely going to want to quit the game because the amount of gold and pay on investment they just straight up delete from your account and asking you to do it again is insane. Now, it sucks for people that abuses like overtuned class, obviously, I guess, yeah. And yeah, if you're abusing like overtuned class and it happens to you, duh, of course it's gonna happen. If it doesn't happen, then the balance patch was, I don't know, jacking off, I guess. Of course it's gonna happen, obviously. But yeah, anyway, this can be any character, any class, anytime a balance patch comes out, you can start praying you don't get artillery treatment. This is ridiculous and unacceptable. Well, you only need to worry about this when you clearly see that, like, you know, your class is obviously overtuned. So yeah, don't make builds overtuned things if you're not for it to be nerfed eventually. If you're not ready for it to be nerfed. Here is the thing, right, you know, it is overtuned with the way what it has, you know. There is two ways you can do it. You can do this, nerf the damage, people are gonna be mad anyway, right? Oh, artillery is now dead, the damage is nerfed, right? So we'll go through the numbers right now. But like, what they take is not like that. What they did is basically they split the double class engraving, so now it's just single class engraving. So it's easier to gear it because it's single class engraving. Second of all, they separate the two right now. If you're wheelchair, right, now basically around 80% of your damage come from the wheelchair, basically. So that's how it goes. The one outside of the wheelchair, less so. It doesn't really like matter that much. So basically that's how it looks like. Now the question is, if you're mad about this, then why do you play wheelchair? Do you wanna play wheelchair or do you wanna play wheelchair with 30-40% firepower? Which one do you want? They're literally basically swapping it basically. They're splitting it right now. So yeah, spec rate isn't changing that much. You just get barrage, remove firepower and get something else. Remove firepower, get adrenaline basically. That's it. So yeah, all he has to change is one accessory with barrage 5. Talking like there's a militia that one day knock on his door and shoot him in the head. Balance change for a broken build, what the fuck? Well, it's not broken, I wouldn't say it's broken. But I would say it is overtuned, so they should tune it down. But I mean, like, if you tune down the damage, people are mad. Luckily, they didn't. The damage is actually stronger. Like, with this build, the damage is actually slightly stronger in the PTR. Now, we're not talking about firepower yet. We'll talk about the firepower for now. But I mean, like, the barrage is actually stronger. A little bit, right there. But the damage distribution is different now. It's more weighted on the wheelchair. Which is supposed to be because you're playing wheelchair, not firepower, right? So there is that as well. So I tested it already, 5x3 and 2 basically. So that's like the max setting in Korea. Level 2 all out attack, because you can use all out attack now, right? In the wheelchair basically. So yeah, and also at the same time, it makes this build much cheaper as well. Since like the damage is now weighted towards like the wheelchair, you only need one gem, damage gem for like barrage. So get all of your other gem, fuse it into the barrage gem, level 10 barrage gem. So yeah. That's basically how it goes right there. So yeah. But for now, like well, speaking of this, but I mean like there are people that are complaining about firepower as well, right? Firepower is obviously overtuned in PTR. I'm pretty sure it's gonna get tuned down. Pretty sure on that, the firepower one. Maybe just a little bit. Maybe like instead of like 25% firepower damage, it gives you like 16 or 20%. Probably that's gonna be the case. Firepower is yeah, kinda like a bit too strong in like a PTR. So if you're worrying about firepower like even stronger than like a barrage, then well, first of all, barrage is gonna be the cheaper setup. Second of all, I think it is overtuned. I think it's gonna get tuned down. So I guess we'll find out for that right there, for like the swift artillery and like the spec wheelchair. So yeah, double cast engraving is giga annoying to build on legendary setup. It's also giga annoying to build it on relic and ancient because everything is expensive. You know how expensive class engraving is. This one is gonna save you gold in the future. Because now you don't have to make double class engraving. All out attack is so cool to unlock, is good damage. It's actually not your priority. Because your Q is not buffed by all out attack. And also like your skills outside of it as well. So it's a later priority for all out attack for you. Zaya, thank you for the follow, man. Welcome, dude. Bosa as well, thank you for the follow. Welcome. So it makes it even harder for people who just started to get decent setup once they hit 1370. Yep. For being up 100% of the time, firepower is insane in PTR right now. I think it's gonna get tuned down. So yeah. So I think you don't have to worry about the firepower in PTR. So for those artillerists, like the thing. Here is the thing about like artillerists, right? What they did is basically they save you gold in the future. But then like you want to replace your firepower with adrenaline later on. Does that make your build irrelevant? Not at all. Because you can still run firepower 3 and like barrage 3 and that's fine as well. Double class engraving. Basically what it does is like it balances out the number of damage that you do again back to like 70 barrage 30% firepower if you're playing the spec wheelchair. That's basically how it goes. That's it basically. That's what you do. So you're not gonna like basically just like invalidate the class basically got deleted. Nah, the playstyle doesn't even change. Like nothing changed, you can literally play the same thing. I tried it already. Tried it already as well. So yeah, Corey, thank you for the resub, man. 4 months. Thank you, dude. Appreciate it, man. Thank you. So yeah. Good evening. Which style do you think is harder to play in endgame, not just Volton and Vikas? Which style? Well, technically, like, the barrage is, like, harder, but not only because it's, like, only because it's, like, it can't move. On, like, certain content, by the way. Some content, not being able to be moved, are easier. For example, in Ghost Phase, right there. If you go barrage, right? Like you will not get knocked off from like by Volton, so that makes it easier. But there are some content that makes it harder as well. So yeah, 2Q is a bit less than a third of the wheelchair combo, I believe. Yeah, so all out attack a bit too weak. It's just like later priority. Like the highest number that I checked was like 5x3 with level 2 all out attack, 5x3 and 2 basically during like my testing on the RTLS PTR. So, but this is basically how it is right here. So yeah, people are just overreacting as usual, overreacting and pessimistic right here. it's essentially deleted, it's actually stronger right now when you make like the proper build for it. And yes, you have to change the build, true. But you've been abusing the old build for too long. Is your old build useless now? Not at all, it's still like basically just fine. You'll play the same as usual, nothing will really change. If anything, it's easier to play right now. Because like you don't have to like go around like with your like firepower. You know when you hit firepower 3 and you get 20 second firepower buff right there? No such thing anymore, you always have it up already. So yeah. Okay Dream, tell people first then. It's kinda like the big PTR changes. There is 4 class that has a big PTR change, right? Arcana, Summoner, Artillerist, and forgot the other one. But yeah, but this is the one right there. Love the unlimited firepower, so many molding. People are molding on Artillerist right now. So yeah, because like Artillerist is like overtuned and stuff like that. And speaking of which, yeah, if people are wondering about that, you only lose 10% of damage reduction. You whenever you go into barrage, you have 10% damage taken reduced still. So I don't know like why you're worrying about this losing thing right here. So yeah, and again, you still have access to your shield. It's not like you lose your shield. So technically, like nothing about your playstyle change. So yeah. Oh, Destroyer is less so, I think. I think it's not Destroyer. Destroyer mainly got like a buff and like quality of life buff. Not like a change or something like that. Like, Artillerists get like a change because like they wanna separate double class. Because obviously double class is overtuned. So, yeah. That's partially how it goes. Firepower no longer goes into wheelchair, right? You don't need to. Because like firepower buffs your normal skill. It doesn't buff your wheelchair skill, so... Okay, Saw Summoner, so many changes. Summoner has like quite a bit, plenty of change here. But yeah, also I believe the new playstyle works a little bit better with Swiftness, right? Since you don't have to wait 30 seconds for the firepower meter to reset. Now you just keep going hitting the boss, whether it's Swiftness or whether you're like a crit, doesn't matter. Just hit the boss the whole time. That's basically what you do. As long as you hit the boss, you don't get lower firepower. That applies to wheelchair as well. Wheelchair won't lower the firepower. Basically, now you can just raise, fill the gauge and transform into like your barrage mode at any time it's possible. Use all of your skill in and out. There is no such thing as cooldown. There is no such thing as like 20 seconds where you have to actually use over there. So yeah, and again, if you use your old setup, double class engraving, it will still be fine. Tested it already. But I mean like the ideal setup, you will replace the firepower with like adrenaline later. You don't have to change it right now. You can change it with like with like ancients here, you'll be fine with it. So yeah, does it play the same? Generally still play the same gambit, yeah. Summoner still on double class, they try to separate it, but it didn't change. If anything, it makes like double class engraving, but they try to separate it. Basically, the way I see it from like the PTR, they try to separate the two. But then like people found out double class engraving is the stronger in Summoner. Not for Artillerist though. So they actually fixed the Artillerist part. So yeah. Astrolithi, big boss, thank you for the follow by the way, welcome, yeah. Before CDR, essentially useless for wheelchair, but it is useless. So yeah, which one has more damage? All about places, I'm just looking at which one is stronger. In the PTR, are you talking about Artillerist or what? Firepower is stronger, for some reason. They're gonna get tuned down, I'm pretty sure on that. So they're actually stronger in like the PTR. So yeah, but that doesn't mean wheelchair get weaker, because wheelchair did get stronger by a little bit. It's just firepower just like soars through because of that like change of class engraving. So yeah, not the time to switch BT, not the time to switch BT. It's not even live in like actual live server by the way. So yeah. Oh, you're pinging the wrong guy in some news, man. Go to Zeal's channel for that. So yeah, flamethrower buff is pretty nice. Flamethrower buff actually makes the cooldown longer, making it like more punishing when you miss it. So yeah, Arty is overall weaker now, which is good now. Arty is not overall weaker, no. They're actually overall stronger now. They're overall stronger because like the wheelchair gets a slight damage buff, the firepower get a massive damage buff, which I think is gonna get undone. So yeah, we'll see, I guess. Yeah, we'll see. BT changes is probably gonna get undone, yeah, probably. So yeah, are Summoner and Hawkeye only left with double class, considering it doesn't change this when balance goes live? Well, we don't know, the PTR is not live yet. But if everything stays the same, probably like Summoner gonna have double class, yeah. Hawkeye doesn't really run double class normally, because like it's too risky, but they can run double class for like potentially a few percent more damage right there. But I'm pretty sure that will change. Here is the thing, right? If you're playing something that is double class engraving right now, expected to be changed. That's how it is. Especially when it's like overtuned like this class, like Artillerist. It's gonna get changed on the next PTR probably. So yeah, that's just how it is. So yeah, Brass Gem to CD Flamethrower Gem, yeah. Okay, the balance changes, fixes, or it might still change. It's gonna change still. I'm pretty sure it's still gonna change. It's PTR for a reason, you know. But yeah. Okay. But anyway, this is like the PTR, like on the thing right here. Done the number for artillerist already. So yeah, I think the here is the thing, right? Here is the summary right here. This is what the PTR is. The PTR is wheelchair artillerist have to change their engraving for the wheelchair. But then you play wheelchair for the wheelchair anyway, not for the firepower, right? Or else like why are you even playing wheelchair if that is the case? So there is that right there. And it becomes it retains its damage, generally slightly stronger, but basically similar. But the playstyle is more on the wheelchair. The firepower is really strong right now. The playstyle doesn't really change that much for firepower, but its damage is way higher. It's gonna get tuned down, I'm pretty sure on that. So we will see on that one. That's basically how it is. And they just split the playstyle of the two of them. So yeah. That's it. Double class sharpshooter in shambles. I'm like, if something's gonna change about double class, could be the sharpshooter one. I'm surprised they didn't actually. I'm surprised they didn't change that. Because I would have thought that they should change that already. So yeah. Is it possible for untouched in PTR to be touched in the live patch? Yes, it's possible for that to happen, yeah. It happens in the last PTR patch. It's also possible for like a change to be completely reverted, just like Soulface, like last patch. So yeah, that's basically how it goes right there. So yep, that's how it is there. Subcoachman, yeah, this is like a artillerist molding here, just like last PTR search blade molding. This time is artillerist. So yeah. But I don't know, that's a summary of the PTR right there. I did my testing on like artillerist. If you want more info, you can just ask away over there. But that's generally how it is, you know. So yeah, for wheelchair molders, let me just tell you, they didn't make you weaker. No, they didn't make you weaker at all. They just like basically separate the class engraving. So you don't have to make double class engraving. You might think it's expensive right now, but it's gonna save you gold in the future, a lot of it. Because double class engraving is nightmare to set up. Ask summoner players if you wanna see that. Whether it's like easy to set up or what. But yeah, it's actually gonna save you gold. So yeah, anyway, that's like the PTR for like artillerist here. And then we'll move on. It's time to go to Hellcloud. So yeah, let's go. We're gonna go back for now.